Good morning, New Canaan High School.
I'm Bridget Salmini, coming to you live from the NCTV studio. Today is September 7th and a day E.
And I'm Luke Rambuya. It feels great to be back again, and we have a lot of news to get to. But first, will everyone please rise for the Pledge of Allegiance?
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America, and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Well, guys, as you've probably heard on the PA system, the Service League of Boys, also known as SLOBS, have a new member meeting next Wednesday, September 12th at 7 o'clock p.m. This is a great group to join if you are looking to give back to the community. Not only this, but it is an opportunity to volunteer with your parents since SLOBS is a parent-student organization.
This week, the theater department held auditions for the underclassmen fall musical and are now heading into auditions for the upperclassmen fall play. As a reminder, juniors and seniors auditions for Letters to Sala will be next week on the 11th and 12th from 2:30 to 6, along with callbacks on the 13th. Please come prepared with a serious monologue and good luck to all auditioning.
Last year, we started honoring two students from each grade as our Students of the Month from September through July. Students are selected for aspects like being respectful to themselves and others and participating the best they can in class. They also have an outstanding attitude, exhibit school pride, and show that they work well with their peers in any situation. Along with that, four faculty members are also selected each month for the Faculty Member of the Month Award. Both students and teachers will be selected over the next few weeks, so do your best to improve our community and your individual behavior.
Speaking of an opportunity to exemplify yourself as an outstanding student, next Thursday, September 13th, the Art Department is hosting the 2018 Summer Art Show from 5 to 9 p.m. in the NCHS lobby. Students, faculty, and staff may submit any type of media, and it will be on display from September 13th through November 2nd. If you'd like to enter your artwork, please give it to any art teacher by the end of the day today.
With the school year now fully underway, on Thursday, September 13th, NCHS is having their annual open house for parents. There will be an 8-block schedule consisting of 10-minute sessions with each of your teachers. For sophomore, junior, and senior parents, the first block begins at 7:15 p.m. Freshman parents, on the other hand, will follow the same schedule, except they should arrive at 6:30 for a 30-minute orientation in the auditorium. So guys, be sure to remind your parents to show up.
Also, with a very busy September schedule, let's take a look at everything going on. Starting on Saturday the 8th, students will be taking the ACT. Then on Monday the 10th, there will be no school to celebrate Rosh Hashanah. Later that week, as we mentioned, the Summer Art Show and Open House are on the 13th. Then moving on to the week following, there will be no school on Wednesday the 19th to celebrate Yom Kippur. And lastly, Spirit Week will be celebrated from the week of the 24th to the 28th, along with the homecoming football game on the 29th. As well as the homecoming dance. This is a pretty eventful month, so make sure to stay on top of everything.
Juniors and seniors, ticketing will officially start this coming Monday for all vehicles in the lot without a parking pass. So if you've not submitted your parking application documentation to the attendance office, be sure to hop on that. As a reminder, along with your application, you must submit a valid driver's license and vehicle registration.
On the subject of IDs, although school pictures were taken this week and you will receive a new one, your ID card will no longer be used for entering home games. Starting next week, there will be a new digital ticketing system that allows you to now use your phone. An email will be sent out next week with instructions how to use it and how to receive your free season pass to all home athletic events.
And with the first football game next week, you're going to need... Speaking of football, let's head on over to our sports reporter, Dylan Pescatore. What do you have for us this week, Dylan?
Fall previews, guys. Hey, NCHS, I'm Dylan Pescatore, here to tell you why every one of our sports teams has a lot of potential to be successful this season. So let's not waste any more time, and let's get right into our Rams sports report. The football team is coming off a disappointing season of 9-3, to New Canaan standards anyway, and the senior captains Jack Conley, Quinton O'Connell, Jack Stewart, and Garrett Braden have a plan to hit the ground running. They're preparing for their first game at St. Joe's tomorrow at 1:30 in Trumbull. The Hogs are currently top-ranked team in the FCAC, so this will be a great first test for the Rams. Over the offseason, the Rams moved up a class, which puts them in the same division of Darien, longtime rival, and Greenwich. Some players to look out for are wide receiver Luke Morton, offensive lineman Will Perrone, and running back Drew Guida. Good luck, guys, and start the season strong. Moving on to soccer, the boys' team is looking to make a comeback this season with their new coach Luke Green after ending the 2017 season with a record of 4-9-3. Now that the team has lost Alex Zirikos, Wes Farley, and Stephen Curiel, the boys are looking at their returning seniors along with two new freshmen, Michael Norn and Tommy Kurz, to add to an already talented team. Captain Luke Crowley told NCTV that they are looking to start off their season with a win and show everyone how much work they've put in throughout the offseason. The boys have a game tomorrow at 12 on Connor Field against Wilton. Go get them, guys. The girls are looking to bounce back from missing STX last year with a 5-5-6 record. Returning captains Caroline Hsu, Caitlin Sparks, and Kendall Patton are looking for underclassmen like Elizabeth St. George and Emma Hsu to step up this year as they look to start off their season with a win as they travel to Wilton to play the Warriors at 4. Good luck, girls. Girls swimming and diving is coming off a very successful 8-1 season, which saw them finishing runner-up in both FCX and States. However, they did lose a couple of key swimmers in Lizzie Colwell, who's now swimming at Vanderbilt, and Caroline Sweeney, who's at Bates College. The good news is that they have plenty of young talent coming up in sophomores Paige Volpe and Maddie Haley, as well as promising freshmen Kate Hunter and Olivia Quinn. Returning senior captains Claire Ross and Bridget Haley look to finish off their NCHS careers with a successful season. Best stated by new head coach Kat Munson, there is a lot of potential for excellence across the board, and I anticipate that several of the girls will be shocking the FCAC with breakout performances this season. Their first meet of the season is at home next Wednesday, September 12th, against Norwalk in the Kelly Devine meet. I know I'll definitely be excited to see what this team can do. Now, this week has definitely been a long one, and our sports teams have had to battle the heat all week. But hopefully this week has geared everyone up for the season ahead. So we can not only starts the regular season for some teams, but the NFL season as well. And I could not be more excited. Have fun watching this weekend and hope all your teams do great, especially my Jets. Anyways, I'll be back next week for the rest of fall previews. Back to you guys.
Thanks, Dylan. You were right. This has been a very long week for all athletes, especially because of the heat.
I know, Bridget. Everyone is wondering when it's finally going to cool down. So let's get the inside scoop from our boy, Harvey Duplock. Harvey?
Thanks, Luke. And you are right. The sports teams have been suffering through this very hot week. But luckily enough, we will see a dip in temperatures coming this weekend. Hello, NCHS. I'm Harvey Duplock, here to give you this weekend's weather. Today is cloudy and expect some PM showers, but we have already seen a low in the 60s, and with the sun being blocked, we will only see a high in the mid 70s. But it is a break from this awful heat, so it will feel great out. And lucky for us, tomorrow will be even cooler. Saturday is going to be the best day this weekend with cloudy skies and a low in the 50s. Meanwhile, it's going to heat up throughout the day until we hit a high in the low 70s. It's going to be beautiful out, so go support our football team at St. Joe's, boys soccer team at Connor Field, and girls field hockey team at Dunning. So now let's talk about Sunday. It will be the coolest day this weekend with cloudy skies and a low in the 50s. However, it will barely heat up until we reach a high in the mid 60s. And sadly, along with the colder weather, we are expecting some PM showers. And I have even more bad news because Monday isn't looking any better. Now, we do have Monday off due to the Jewish holiday Rosh Hashanah. So if you are celebrating, I hope you have a great holiday. But sadly, we are expecting some showers throughout the day. On the other hand, temperatures will heat up, much like Friday, with a low in the 60s and a high in the 70s. Luke, Bridget, this weekend is looking good, and I hope you guys, along with everyone here at NCHS, makes the best of this weekend. I've been Harvey Duplock, and back to you, Bridget and Luke.
Thanks, Harvey. And yes, the weather should play no role in the attendance at the game tomorrow. Again, this Monday there will be no school for the celebration of Rosh Hashanah, so for those of you not celebrating, enjoy the day off.
I know I'll be enjoying the day off. Now, before we go, we would like to wish a very happy birthday to Jacqueline Carrasco and Gabriella Lamone. If you have any announcements, be sure to email us at nctv78@gmail.com or tweet at us at nccv78 a week before the Friday broadcast. This has been Luke Rambuya.
And I'm Bridget Salmini. We leave you now with our new TV2 students who hit up the streets to see how summer and the first week of school was for our students and faculty. Have an amazing weekend, NCHS.
All right, guys, we're here in the library now to check out what the teacher's been doing this summer. Ms. Chason, can you tell us about your summer?
Well, I had a very good summer. My husband and I went to Quebec City, which I loved. I felt like I was living in France.
Francais.
Yes, very nice. I had a great summer.
I'm Abby Bergenheim, and this is...
James Singer.
With...
Timothy Hardy.
What'd you do over the summer?
I worked.
Now we found ourselves in the math office with a couple more favorite teachers. We got Ms. Treglio here and Ms. Jenko. Guys, how was your summer?
It was fantastic. I had a lot of fun playing with my two daughters. I dyed my hair purple, pink, green, blue. It was fantastic.
I went on a pretty crazy trip. I went to Helsinki, St. Petersburg, Tallinn, Stockholm. It was pretty amazing.
What's it like being a senior so far?
I mean, it's an honor. From going from freshman all the way up to senior year, I mean, like, you know, I was always at the bottom, but now I'm at the top and it feels great.
All right, so guys, NCTV wants to know, what's the most fun thing you guys did this summer?
I went to Hawaii.
I also went to Hawaii and I saw this guy there.
So what's it like being a senior now?
It's pretty good. A lot of freeze, that's a plus.
Were your expectations met so far?
So far, I could live this life.
Now we're live in the office with new assistant principal, Ms. Carrera. We have to ask you, because we've heard many rumors about Mr. Egan, what's it like working with him, and is it true he has 10 cats?
I have heard all wonderful things about Mr. Egan.
Hey, what are you guys talking about?
That's how great of a principal you are. And
how great it is to work with you.
I am sure you're only saying good things.
All good. Thank you.
Well, guys, teachers told us to be quiet, being too loud, being cue out. Shh.